the nature of this opera requires just a word of introduction. How do you introduce the Holocaust, you know? I thought that some words from the wife of the Holocaust survivor, about whom this opera is written, would be appropriate. It's written about a man named Jack P. Eisner, whom I knew personally and was friends with him a few years before he died, and I was actually with him and his wife at the last moments of his life. And the fact that I happen to be American Indian writing about the Jewish Holocaust opera has puzzled many people. And I, at the time this thing was conceived, it seemed perfectly natural to me. I was in Israel, and I had a debut of a duet, in fact, the duet that's going to be played here tomorrow. And I met Jack. I was introduced to him, and the idea came into being, and myself, Mr. Eisner, and another friend were walking home from synagogue, and this was in Caesarea, actually. And my friend said, "Dave, you're a composer. Jack, you've got a great story. Dave, why don't you write an opera?" It was that simple. And I suddenly was enthralled, and I said, "I will write the libretto. I will write the music. I will write the orchestration." I just became absorbed in it. And Jack said, "We have a word for you in Jewish, chutzpah." So I undertook this project, and part of it has actually been recorded by the Polish National Radio Symphony, part of this scene, in fact, but it has yet to be produced. So what you're actually hearing here is the first public performance of any portion of this opera, and if the vision ever materializes, it is the first grand opera on the Holocaust. There's been one-act operas, there's been various attempts at musical portrayals. It doesn't lend itself well to a typical opera plot, not if you're writing about the Holocaust itself, which is what I have tried to do. You can write about love stories with the Holocaust background, a terrible social upheaval. You can write about that, but I tried to write about the upheaval itself, using the characters to express those elements. This particular scene is particularly touching to me because it's a scene where the young boy, Jacek, he's only 13, 14 years old, he decides that he's going to defend his people with force. And this is a nice Jewish Orthodox family in Warsaw, Poland. You don't think about things like that. Not in that day, not in 1938 and 39. You don't think about violence for any reason. But he did. He wanted to be a war hero. Like, why can't Jewish people be war heroes? Why do we have to be beat up all the time? 13-year-old kid. And to hear him tell this story personally, I mean, I couldn't resist the opportunity. Yes, I wanted to write I wanted control over the entire creative process here. And I want to read just something from his wife about this subject of why me. When I ask Jack, why David, he said, "Well, he is a native. He is an Indian. His people were conquered and meant to be eliminated, so his soul will understand my suffering." That's from the man himself. And I will also testify that I have not written an American Indian opera. This is my first opera. And those groups of people that have undergone cataclysmic sufferings, it's hard to grasp. And I have to say this. My composition teacher, is here in the audience. And we had a conversation one time about grasping this kind of thing. Mr. Asia, would you mind standing? This is Daniel Asia from the University of Arizona in Tucson. My teacher. I said, I'm not ready to do the Comanche thing. It's too close. So I used a prepared script, the Jewish Holocaust, where every aspect of human suffering is carefully expressed, carefully kept track of, carefully recorded, with a scientific exactness. It's a guide in this sort of thing. It's a guidebook. And I used it. And that's why I think I'm trying to account for my chutzpah here to want to grasp the whole thing, because I knew something told me inside that this was what I needed. This was going to prepare me for my own story someday. But in the meantime, this is the, as I said, the first public performance of any portion of this opera, and I hope you enjoy it. I hope it's meaningful to you. Thank you very much.